Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, I will discuss one-liners from dermatology subject with Hansen's disease in particular, which were tested till December 2019 in various national and state level exams. Okay, let's start. There are some 60 one-liners and important topics which I am going to discuss now, which are very much high yielding and must read for before NEET exam. Let's begin. Leprosy does not involve CNS or uterus. If ovary and uterus are given, then uterus is a better option. Leprosy spreads by breast milk, transplacental root and droplet, but remember it's not spread by insect bite. Split skin smear is negative in pure neuritic type of leprosy, TT, Hansen's, indeterminate Hansen's. The reason being all of them are posibacillary. Best site for SSS is in untreated cases is earlobes, and if for treated cases it is dorsal of the fingers. Most common type of leprosy in India is BT Hansen's. Nerve abscess is most commonly seen in BT Hansen's. Nerves are not thickened in indeterminate variant of Hansen's, and skin biopsy is used for the diagnosis of indeterminate Hansen's. And you should remember that indeterminate form is not included in Ridley-Joplin's classification. Leucio reaction is seen in leprosy. Here we can see clinically ulcer or necrotic lesions. Verso cells are seen in leprosy. Lepra cell is a histiocyte. Satellite lesions are seen in borderline tuberculoid leprosy, BT Hansen's. Also, you should remember that satellite lesions are seen in sporotrichosis and also candidial infections. Inverted saucer shaped lesion, or also called as puncture out lesion, is seen in borderline or mid borderline type of leprosy. Nerve biopsy is taken to diagnose neuritic kind of leprosy from radial cutaneous nerve. Sensory nerves are chosen for nerve biopsies. Skin biopsy in leprosy is characterized by periappendageal bacilli, periappendageal lymphocytosis and perivascular lymphocytosis. Lepromatous leprosy, we can see presence of globi, subepidermal free zone or gren zone, decreased cell mediated immunity. But you will not see subepidermal granulomas, because in lepromatous pole the lymphocytes are reduced and cell mediated immunity is low. In leprosy, which of the following is seen? We can see abnormal electromyographic findings. There will be voluntary muscle wasting, and there will be decreased response to tactile sensation, and also we can see increased response to tactile sensation, in particularly speaking in reactions. But remember, proprioception and vibration sense are not impaired. They are intact. Earliest sensation to be lost in Hansen's is temperature, and to be in particular it is cold and hot differentiation. Lesions which are not seen in leprosy are vesicles. Same like in secondary syphilis, here vesicles are not found. Symmetrical multiple lesions are seen in lepromatous type of leprosy. Features of leprosy are leonine facies, saddle nose, lag of thalamus. How can you say that the leprosy is active? Is you can find new skin lesions, nerve tenderness and erythema. You should remember that there is 100% involvement of neural tissues in leprosy. Iris pearl seen in leprosy. Leprosomal test is positive in tuberculoid type of leprosy. And remember that leprosomal test is only useful for prognostication of patients, but it is not helpful for diagnosis of leprosy. Type 1 reaction is seen in BT Hansen's, BB Hansen's and BL Hansen's, but remember it is BT, more of BT. Erythronodosum leprosum is seen in LL more than BL type of Hansen's. The main cytokine involved in the erythronodosum leprosum reaction is TNF-alpha, tumor necrosis factor alpha. Manifestations of ENL include all except, remember, the pancreatitis is not caused and there will not be any arthritis. Patient will only complain of arthralgia, that is pain in the joints. Type 1 reaction is commonly seen in borderline tuberculoid PT Hansen's. Here comes some important one-liners regarding medications. Remember, blindly the drug of choice for both type 1 and type 2 reactions is steroids. And drug of choice in type 1 reaction associated with severe neuritis is also steroids. And treatment of severe ulnar neuritis in borderline tuberculoid leprosy is, we should continue MDT and also we should start steroids. And drug of choice for recurrent erythronodosum leprosum, that is type 2 reaction, is steroids and clofazamine, because clofazamine has an anti-inflammatory activity. Thalidomide is a drug of choice for type 2 lepra reaction. Antileprotic drug useful in lepra reactions is clofazamine. This is the same thing. And you should remember that thalidomide has no role in type 1 reaction or reversal type of lepra reaction. And cyclosporine is not useful in type 2 reactions. Duration of treatment for multibacillary leprosy according to World Health Organization is 1 year. And if it is possibacillary, it is 6 months. The regimens are same for both of them. Only the duration is different. Under leprosy eradication program, management of single lesion, we give rifampicin, clofazamine and dapsone for 6 months. That is, the regimen followed for possibacillary is used here. In some books, it is still given as ROM therapy, but it is not correct. It is incorrect. World Health Organization regime for possibacillary leprosy is dapsone, rifampicin, clofazamine given for 6 months. In multibacillary leprosy, the follow-up of examination after adequate treatment should be, now the recent guidelines say that there is no requirement for any kind of follow-up both in multibacillary as well as in possibacillary. Best method of treatment of ulnar nerve abscess, like you all remember and you all know that anywhere abscess, incision in drainage is the treatment of choice. The most effective drug against M. leprae is rifampicin. In fact, after 4 days of administration of rifampicin, it was noted that there were no bacilli remaining in patients. According to WHO, latest treatment of leprosy, 6 months treatment for possibacillary. Clofazamine usage in leprosy patients will cause hyperpigmentation, discoloration of body secretions and ichthyosis like skin changes. Sometimes patients do ask to change the medication because of all these side effects. So you should remember that. Ridley-Joplin classification is bacteriological, immunological, clinical and histological. I hope you can understand what I am trying to say by highlighting these letters in that same order. If a claw hand develops in a patient with leprosy, the deformity is grade 2. Cell-mediated immunity is maximally suppressed in lepromatous leprosy. Tuberculoid leprosy is characterized by non-caseating granulomas. Leprosy causes renal involvement. We'll see most commonly there will be secondary amyloidosis. But if at all glomerulonephritis is the given in the options, then you should mark mesangioproliferative glomerulonephritis more than membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis. So if mesangioproliferative is not in the option, then membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis will be the answer. Onion skin appearance on histopathology will be seen in BL Hansen's. Dose of dapsone is 1 to 2 milligrams per kilogram. Antibiotic against leprosy are ofloxacin and clarithromycin, but not azathioprine. Immunoprophylaxis has an important role in leprosy. The ones which are used are BCG vaccination, Mycobacterium indicus prani MIP, Mycobacterium vaccae. In severe cases of Lucio phenomena, exchange transfusion has been used as a treatment modality. Lepra reaction, if not treated, can lead to permanent deformity. So, early diagnosis of the patients with lepra reactions is of utmost importance. That's it, friend. These were the important high-yield must-read one-liners from Hansen's topic. If you wish to revise these one-liners again, I have posted all these into my blog. You can check my blog. I'll give the link in the description below or this video. That's it, friends. If you like the video, please do give it a thumbs up and share it among your friends. And if you have any doubts regarding any of the one-liners which I have told here, or you have any doubts related to skin, please do comment below. I'll be more than happy to answer them. And if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, do click that red subscribe button to get the notifications which I will put each and every day, which I'm planning to do from now. I would make such videos with high yielding one liners till NEET PG, which is scheduled on January 5th, 2020. After the NEET PG, I am planning to do complete lecture videos completely for free and available for all of you. That's why I'm asking, subscribe and hit that bell icon if you wish to get notification immediately after I upload the videos. And if you wish to join my Telegram and WhatsApp groups, the links for the same I am putting in the description box below. Once again, thank you guys for watching my video. We'll meet you again later. Bye.